Can you eat foods that help with your brain power and even stave off Alzheimer's? A national expert and author is in to tell us, yes, you can. Also, I'm wearing a necklace from You Won't Believe Who. And finally, we're gonna make some wonderful breakfast items and have some positive thoughts with my very favorite personal trainer. Stay with us. Welcome to Full Plate, and like the song says, I'm so glad you're here. Also here today is a national expert on plant-based eating. He's the person that kind of counsels Ellen DeGeneres on how to eat with no plants in your, no animals in your diet, actually. He does no meat, he does no eggs, no cheese. It's really good food, but he also says that if you eat this way, it's going to help your memory. Obviously, I don't eat this way yet. But he came in and explained to us the foods that can really help your memory now and in the future and how they can also be tasty. Take a look at our interview with Dr. Neil Barnard. Okay, so the book is Power Foods for the Brain by Dr. Neil Barnard. Welcome, Dr.
Thank
Barnard.
You.
Thank
it's
you
great.
For making the trip.
It's great to be here.
Okay, so what are power foods for the brain?
Well, you know, a lot of people are worried that when we're young, we're not as sharp as we ought to be, and then we're worried that if we're older, maybe we're at risk for those serious memory problems that we saw our grandparents go through. Well, we now know that there are certain foods that make that more likely, but there are other foods that are really in your corner and help your brain to stay oxygenated and help keep you healthy.
That's fantastic, because I mean, I'm in my 40s now, and I'll struggle for a name, or I'll struggle for where did I leave this, and you worry, is this a serious problem?
Yeah.
And so you say there are things, what should we be eating to change maybe or stop this from happening?
Okay, there are some things that I really like to emphasize a lot. And let me start here, these green leafy vegetables that look so pretty, whether it's kale or collards or spinach, those green leafy vegetables have a B vitamin called folate. The name comes from foliage, like leaves. Folate is a B vitamin. It protects the brain. Beans also have a vitamin called B6. That protects the brain, too. And so if these are part of your routine, you're giving your brain the vitamins that help it to stay young, to stay healthy. But a lot of people, these are the first things that they neglect. Right. Our grandparents knew about them. A lot of us have forgotten about it. Let me also point out, walnuts, almonds. These nuts have vitamin E in them. That's a brain protector, too. The danger is they're a little bit addicting. So you know how it is.
You can overeat.
You can overeat nuts, and because they're fatty, you could then gain weight. So the way I do it is I'll have maybe an ounce. Mm-hmm. An ounce is the amount that fits into the palm of your hand. If it hits your fingers, that's more than an ounce. but then, most importantly, you don't then shove it in your mouth. What I do is I crumble those walnuts up, put them on my salad, or on my oatmeal, or on my pancakes, and that way it's an ingredient. I'm not going to go back for more. So about an ounce is good. Walnuts, pecans, also the seeds, sunflower seeds, sesame seeds, they all have that protective vitamin E, and frankly, they add a nice crunch.
And these foods really are, people see improvement with their cognition, their memory. Talk about the benefit, you know, the intellectual benefit you're getting if you're eating this way, if you change your diet in this way.
Researchers in Chicago in 1993 set up a big study called Chicago Health and Aging Project, and they tracked what people ate, and they showed that the people who got the most, the walnuts and the almonds, and the vitamin E that they contain, their risk of developing Alzheimer's disease late in life was cut by anywhere from 25 to up to 70%.
Say that 70% is a shocking percentage to say that you could really have that kind of a benefit. Now, it is a vegan diet, yes?
Well, the people who do the very best are the people who avoid the animal products completely. And I always say that a vegan is not somebody from the planet Vegas. the idea is that you get away from the animal products. What you've done is you've gotten away from all the animal fat, because these same researchers showed that as good as vitamin E is, that bacon grease isn't really doing your brain any favors. It increases the risk of Alzheimer's. So we like that kind of shift. And the closer you get to that, the better off you are. So let's say we're at an Italian restaurant, and the waiter says, angel hair pasta, what do you want on top of it? I would say, let's have the marinara sauce or the wild mushrooms or the artichoke hearts. Those are always the foods that skip the bad fats and have the healthy fiber that's good for the brain.
I'm saying, if you look at the back of this book here, you've got some pretty big name fans, Ellen DeGeneres, Alicia Silverstone. These are people that, I mean, they're well known for really having this diet be part of what they feel is beneficial in their lives. So, I mean, they know something we don't. Maybe it's what you've got going on here.
Well, everybody's doing it for different reasons. For some people, they walk into it because, well, I just want a trimmer waistline. So we're getting away from the bad fats for that reason. And there's nothing like the vegetables and fruits to help us stay trim. For others, they might say, well, I don't want to have heart problems again. Bill Clinton. For years, he was known for jogging to the nearest fast food chain. Well, now he follows a totally plant-based diet. He lost weight, looks better than he's looked in years. Yeah. Some people do it because it's good for the athletics. But for me as a doctor, I'm thinking about, we've got Alzheimer's. We have 5 million Americans who have it now. The numbers are going up and up and up. The more we bring the healthy foods into our diet, the more we get the bad stuff out, the better off we're going to be.
And so you give a 21-day, is this in this book, the 21 days we were talking about? So if you can try it for 21 days, talk about that. That's a kind of a, let's immerse ourselves in it for 3 weeks.
Right. You know, I really like to say to people, let's make a big change so that you can feel what it's like. Mm-hmm. So if you make only a tiny little change on Monday and one the following Saturday,
the impact is small.
The impact is too small.
Okay.
So I say, let's make a big change, but it's going to sound daunting if I say, throw out the meat, throw out the dairy. Person think, I can't do that. So what I say is, let's make a big change, but only for 3 weeks. At the end of that time, two things have happened. The first is that people feel healthier. They're losing weight. Their energy is coming back. They feel more centered. They're sleeping better. But the other thing is, their tastes change. And you know, you're not going to expect it, but it happens. You know how when people switch from whole milk to skim milk, at first, oh, the skim milk is
just like water that's white.
It's white. Exactly. But then after a couple of weeks, what happens? They get used to it. And then you go back, and if you ever try whole milk again, suddenly it tastes like cream.
Yeah, I can't drink whole milk anymore. I think the best example is an apple. When I am really following my, you know, low fat, eating a lot of vegetables, I'll have an apple and it tastes like candy. I mean, it tastes like the best. How is this apple so good? And it's when you get yourself used to having the fresh food.
That's exactly right. And if I say to a person, let's try a vegan diet, I have to say the first week it does seem pretty light. Yeah. You're going to think, oh, I've got to acquire a taste for folk music now. You know, whatever.
I'm wearing hemp clothes. Dr. Barnard.
Exactly. Got to shop in a store with a cashier's name, Sunshine. However, after.
But it's not like that. We promise.
No, after a week or so, you start to think, wait a minute. You got some recipes that are better than what I'm making now. And your energy is better, and your doctor starts saying, your diabetes is better, your cholesterol is better, your blood pressure is coming. It's better than it's been in years. And after about 3 weeks, your tastes have adjusted, and you think, let's talk longer term.
That's right. You're asking Sunshine and Mary at the end of this thing. All right, so we want to let people know where you can find the book. This book is available on where all fine books are sold, in the bookstore and also online.
Exactly, and I hope people will drop by their local bookseller, who would appreciate their business.
Absolutely. Sunshine, the bookseller, would also appreciate that. So the book is Power Foods for the Brain. Dr. Barnard, thank you. And we're going to come back in a little while and make, or at least see how we can make some of these great dishes with these great ingredients.
You bet.
Dr. Barnard was so fascinating. We do a second segment with him. Stay tuned for that next week. We're going to talk about the recipes that he's got in his book, and he's even going to let me make a few of the dishes. Again, that's next week on Full Plate. This week, though, you're going to find out where I got this necklace. It's from somebody famous. Stay with us.
Don't miss the